Welcome. Today's tutorial is about how you can manually register two scans together in the Leica Cyclone registration software. It doesn't matter if you use the BLK edition or the regular edition. I like to give you a few introduction what you can do and how it works. So first of all, we have a little project here. It's separated in two overview maps. You see here, I have map one is called hotel, and then I have a second map. It's called bathroom. So we have these two sections. And the question is, how can I connect these two? Because this is one job and I like to have them in one file. So what I'm gonna do is, first of all, for the orientation. I mean, if you look to a project and if you did not scan it by yourself, if you get the data from your colleague or from a service company, a service provider, then sometimes it's hard to know which scan goes to where. So first of all, I like to show, of course, you can go and jump in with a right click on the scan and can say jump into the scan and then see the view and blah, 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 blah. And you can do it scan by scan. That's very painful because you waste a lot of time. The second point is you can select the scan. And then if you select it, you see the red mark here. And then you can hover over the little image icon and then you see a preview of the image. So that helps sometimes to find the right scan. So what I need to connect. So in this case, I know it's scan number four. So you see this is a door. Here's the bathroom on the side. Okay. What you can do, what I personally prefer to do is I make a right click on the hotel and then I say export panoramic images and then just JPEG and then put them in the folder and say, okay. And then you can export them. It's saying here, I did this already because I did already the German tutorial. So I have it already. So if you click on yes, then it will export the panorama images. And then I'm using this. If I go to my folder, that's called panos. Let me open it here. You see panos. So on, then I can double click on the images and I can move forward and backward just using the arrow keys on the keyboard. So that's very common and very easy to use and you have the huge view. So I recommend to do this and then put these images on the other screen, on your second screen. So you can navigate very easy through the images and then you know which image you have to select. So and in our case, we know already the connection needs to be between scan number four and scan number three. If you look for the name, here's a little icon. You can turn it on and off. I don't use it actually because it's covering too much of my view. So now what I'm doing is I'm selecting the group and I just drag and drop the group into the same card, overview card. And then you see it's somewhere here and of course it has to come here. So what you're gonna do is you select the scan you like to connect and the second one by holding down the string or the control key. And then you go to visual registration and then you jump into this typical view you know from the Cyclone Field app. And you do the same thing actually here. So you move it in the right position and I recommend pick some corner, pick some unique feature and then just take this unique feature and put it directly on top of the other one. So that is one mouse movement. If you are too fast, you can hold down the Alt key and then it's slowing down the movement. And then I place it in the same position. Then the second thing you need to do is you need to orientate. So you click in the same point again. And if you hold down the left button of your mouse, then you can drag this little, this little line, and then you can spin it and turn it in the right position. So you have the right orientation, and then you can set connect in the line. One thing you need to know, if the height is not fitting, for example, like this, let's say we have this issue here, because we went up some stairs or stuff like this, and you try to connect these, it looks good in the top view, but if you click then it gives you the error message, it's not gonna work. So then remember, maybe the height is not correct. So what I'm doing, I'm moving it in the right position. And again, looks same way like before, but now it works perfectly. Okay, so I confirm with okay. And now I have my whole connection. In some cases, you like to keep the project separated. Let's say you scan the first and second and third floor. Then, of course, you don't want all the scans in one site. So what you can do now is you can select your first scans, the first area, and just drag them back into your sitemap. Now you see here, there's a great spot for the connected scan. And if I click on it, I jump into the next sitemap. So I can jump forward and backward very easy. So easy navigation, very, very nicely. So the other way to do is we cut off this connection again, and then we do the same thing. You don't have to drop the group, especially if you have bigger jobs. It's not very helpful because you get screwed by the information. So sometimes I just take one scan and drag them into the sitemap, and it's here now. And you see it has a connection to other scans, but I don't mind in this matter. And then again, control key, hold down, and then go to visual registration and do the same process from the beginning. I will not repeat the same steps, but what I show you is there is also a split view, so you can jump into the split view. That's especially useful if you work outside and you have complicated situations. Sometimes you can make the cloud-to-cloud registration with the split view, because you can pick in more detail what are identical points. Very, very hard to use in my opinion, because it's very hard to decide what tool is activated. I mean, you see it here, but let's say we pick three corners for now. So I switch the view here to intensity so I can see my edge here. And then I have to activate the pick tool, and then I pick one and two. I cannot see it in this view. Maybe there's a setting in the viewing. I'm not sure about it. But anyway, if I go back, then I see here's a little icon and here's the icon. So I did one. So now is the critical point. If you now try to move your view, you will pick some point and everything is screwed up. And you have to delete all points and then do it all over. So what you have to do before you touch it is you have to switch to this tool and then look to the next corner here. And then again, activate this tool and then click and click. And then again, go back here and say, let's say we use this one. And this one, I explained in the German tutorial, don't click edges like this, because there's a high risk that you're not picking the point on the closet. In this example, you're picking a point behind it, and then the whole registration is screwed up. So try to choose a point what is safe to click. In this case, I turn again intensity on, so I can see a little bit better here. I take this one and this one. And now I have three points, that's enough. You can also pick four or five, whatever you need. And then you can say, do the registration. And you see, it's doing it. Of course, doing the cloud-to-cloud registration. And again, we have our registered project. And now I just will bring back the one scan, so everything is clear again. Already, that's the manual step to do the registration on your computer. If you are back in the office, high recommended, don't do it like this. You have to do it, of course, sometimes, but force your team to do it outside, because if there is an issue with registration, on site you will see it and you can fix it. You can do an additional scan. You won't be able, if you have a bad connection here, you won't be able to do magic. I mean, if it works, it's fine. If not, it's not working. And then, of course, you can do some magic, but I will not recommend this in the tutorial because it's not the best way to work with, and it has a high risk that you have some planning issues later on. Then one thing, we have a tutorial, it's called manual registration in Register if you have a lot of trees and stuff like this, so you can search in our help center. There is some very interesting additional feature how you can clip off cloud sections for the cloud-to-cloud registration, so you can fit scans together even if the environment is very difficult and complicated. So hope that makes sense for you. I'm looking forward to get the thumb up if you like to, if that will help us, you know, YouTube and Google will force us to do. But anyway, hope it makes sense and you liked it. Thank you so much and see you next time. Bye bye.